So you're thinking about moving to Florida. Did you know that Tampa Bay is one of the most affordable areas of its size in the nation? I'm going to show you the true cost of living here, so stay tuned. You don't want to miss it. I'm Victoria McGuire, realtor here in Tampa, Florida, and today I'm going to cover the true cost of living here, from taxes to housing to groceries, gas, and more. First and foremost, we have no state income tax. That is a huge savings for most families. I mean, think about it. In New York or California, you're going to pay between 8 and 12% of your income just in your state income tax. For most people, this is very significant, and that's going to be thousands of dollars that you save right off the bat just by moving to Florida. There's also sales tax to consider. Recently, sales tax did go up in Hillsborough County, which is our main county. It went up to 8.5%. We also have Pinellas County, where our beaches are, and Pasco County, just north of Tampa. And those counties are both still at 7%. That tax rate is pretty much in line with much of the United States. And yet another tax, so many taxes, property tax. The 2019 tax rate for homes in Tampa was 2.003, making Florida taxes a tiny bit more affordable in comparison to the rest of the country, but definitely making it one of the lower property tax rates in the entire state. Next, let's talk housing. Tampa has a very affordable housing price compared to other states. As of 2019, the median home price in Tampa was only $219,400. This is below the national average, and especially when you compare to New York, where the median value is about $652,000, or California at $578,000. Wow! Now, rent prices. It's currently cheaper to buy than to rent in most areas because mortgage rates are so low and rent prices just keep going up and up. But as you can see on the graph here, rent prices range from $950 a month to $1,650 a month, depending on the size home you're wanting to rent. This is much lower than many areas of the United States. So, what else could we discuss? How about utilities? We are pretty close to the national average for this, and I'm going to use my own home for example purposes. I have a pretty large home at about 3,400 square feet, and we do have a pool, so keep that in mind. But my average electric bill is about $250 a month, and my average water bill is about $100 a month, and we are a family of four right now. My house doesn't have gas, but what I understand from some of my friends and customers is that gas runs about $40 a month on average. And we use our gas here to heat our pools, our stoves, and maybe your heat. Although we don't really use our heat very often. So we've covered taxes, housing, and utilities. Now let's just talk about like some everyday stuff. Gas prices. Gas prices are super low right now, since I'm shooting this in the middle of the coronavirus, but my local Circle K, just down the street from my house, the price the other day was $1.85, and there's a 7-Eleven just a little bit further down that's about the same price at $1.85. I do recall before the coronavirus shutdown that our prices were more in the $2.40-$2.50 range. What about dinner out? We love to hit our local Mexican restaurant pretty regularly. And even with the jumbo margaritas that we can't resist during happy hour, we end up spending right around $40 for a meal. And that does include a tip. So eating out in our area is still quite affordable. Now, what about groceries? Here are some of the staples as of today, May 22nd, 2020, at Winn-Dixie, a local grocery store here. We also have Publix. There's pretty much a Publix on every corner. They are beautiful stores. According to Best Places, Tampa grocery prices are a bit below the national average, but I find that it really depends on where you shop. And though I love Publix, I do think that their prices are pretty high. So if you're going to maybe go to Sam's Club or Costco, you're going to get much more affordable prices than you would at other places, especially if you have a big family. So here are some pictures that I took the other day when I was at Winn-Dixie. You can see there's milk, eggs, bread. Had to throw in a picture of beer, which I consider to be a staple. And I also threw in this picture of Highlight Beer, which is a local brewery. Cigar City Brewing makes this beer here locally, and it's delicious, so I had to throw that in. So as you can see, living in Tampa is quite affordable, and to me, there's no better place to be. I hope that you have found this video informative. If there's any other questions you have, don't hesitate to reach out to me. And remember, if you're even thinking about moving to the Tampa Bay area, you've got to give me a call, shoot me a text, or send me an email. Whatever form of communication you prefer is fine with me. I'm always available, and I've got your back when it comes to moving to Tampa. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button below.